All right, we are live. I am going to be updating you on the YouTube advertiser boycott monetization crisis. I will tell you whether it has gotten any better since yesterday. Short answer is no. I've received a letter from YouTube, okay? And I am going to be showing you this letter. It looks like we're already having some pretty significant audio sync issues. So let me see if I can clear up some things over here to make the system run a little bit faster. Is that working for anybody? How's the audio video at this point? You tell me. I had a bunch of stuff queued up that I wanted to show you, and I think that that is slowing down the entire stream. So I don't know. I'm going to dive into this though. So let's sort of start at the beginning. Over the last 4 days, a number of YouTube producers, including me, including Kyle Kolinsky, including The Young Turks, just a lot of people noticed that YouTube revenue, which is one of the number one funding sources for shows like ours, just fell off a cliff. I think on March 31st, our channel made something like $70, which is, you know, a tiny fraction of what the channel had been making. April 1st, it got even worse. It was down to like $46. So it's bad. It's really, really bad. And what this is all about is threats and actual, so advertisers who, big advertisers that pulled money or threatened to pull money from YouTube because of a couple of reports, including one from the Wall Street Journal, that the that ads were being shown in front of just obviously trolling, hateful content, videos with the N-word in the title, all sorts of stuff. Amazing Atheist has been hit, Secular Talk has been hit, we've been hit, a lot of people have been hit, and so what this has resulted in is a literal crisis for the David Pakman Show. As you may know, direct memberships purchased on our website at davidpakman.com are the number one funding source for the show, barely. And the number two funding source at roughly 40-42% of our revenue is YouTube revenue. So it's a big deal. Now, we have no direct relationship with YouTube advertisers. People who know about YouTube know that there is essentially no connection whatsoever. We've never spoken to a YouTube advertiser because YouTube does this great thing, which is we produce the content, they go and sell to advertisers, and the ads show up in front of our video. So it's great in that if an advertiser wanted to influence us, they would sort of have to go out of their way to figure out how to contact us and then even prove that they're actually buying ads on YouTube. It's a really, really good thing, in the sense that it prevents even possible coordination, or at least easy coordination, between producers and advertisers. It's all really good. Ads disappear. So if you've been on our channel over the last few days, you might have noticed that there are absolutely no ads playing, barely any ads playing on any of our content. And in fact, what's amazing is that of the $46 that our YouTube channel made on March 1st, I believe it was, only 16 of those dollars were from actual ads that showed. The rest was what's called YouTube Red partner revenue, which is that individuals have these, I believe it's $10 a month YouTube subscriptions, and they are able to basically force the money to us by watching our videos. But of the $46, only $16 was from people watching ads before our videos. So as you can probably tell from a strictly math perspective, this is a big deal. Now, I wrote to YouTube about this, and I'm going to show you in a second the letter that YouTube wrote back to me. And yesterday on the program, I predicted that what I would hear back from YouTube is a form letter saying, we're constantly working to optimize the combination of content and advertisers and blah, 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 blah. That is exactly what I got. Okay, so here is the letter that I received from YouTube today. Let's go through it piece by piece, and you'll see how absurd it is. And let me make sure that this is actually showing. Can people see the letter? I've just put it up on the screen. I don't know how delayed the live stream is. I just want to make sure. I apologize for this. I'm just checking the live stream to make sure that the letter is up. Yes, it is. Okay, it's up. So Let's see if I can zoom into this even more for you, and then we'll look at it. What's the best way to do it? Hi, David. Thank you for your message and providing the detailed description. I had a quick look at your channel, and I must say, you're doing great. Of course, couldn't even do Y-O-U apostrophe R-E. You're doing great. The subscribers you've garnered is just amazing. So we're off to a bad start, right, folks? I think all of us can tell. But this is not the meat of it. Let's get to the meat of it. While I was reviewing your channel and videos, as you rightly mentioned, I can confirm that monetization is enabled and that ads are serving. Many factors are considered when serving an ad, ranging from the content of the video to the country the viewer is located in. So this is a non-starter, right? Because we've had a YouTube channel for 9 years and ads show on almost every video all the time. And most of our viewers are from the United States. So this is part of the form letter that makes no sense. So we cannot guarantee that a certain number of ads will appear or what type of ad will appear. You can learn how ads display on videos here. Okay, useless link. Completely useless link for someone who's been on YouTube for 9 years. It continues. It's also important to note that ads don't necessarily run on a video every single time someone watches it, and where the video is being watched, desktop, mobile, embedded, etc., can also impact whether or not an ad will run. Our video monetization troubleshooter can be a really helpful tool to figure out why you might not be seeing ads on videos. With regard to revenue, we want to be as transparent as possible about the process to help creators understand how revenue is made and why it fluctuates. Advertising revenue is based on a number of different factors and may not be directly correlated to video views, and not all views are equal in terms of revenue. These factors include advertiser bidding, availability, and demand for your videos. So again, this is a total non-starter because from one day to the next, all ads disappeared from all videos. Now, if it was only our new content that was so controversial and so graphic in nature that it was not monetizable, then you could understand that the new videos wouldn't be monetized, but our backlog of 14,000 videos that have had ads on them for years would still be monetized. Not the case. So this is totally bogus, right? It continues. Since you're seeing fluctuations in your revenue or ads, and if you encounter this over the next few weeks, it may be because we're fine-tuning our ad system to address the concerns detailed in our blog post. Now, if you click on that, it goes to something very, very general about, you know, matching ads and advertisers and producers accurately. While this can be unsettling, we're working as fast as we can to improve our system so that advertisers feel more confident in our platform and revenue continues to flow over the long term. Well, there is no flow. There is no flow. As you're aware, advertising is seasonal, which it's a total non-starter. Fourth quarter of the year tends to do better for YouTube revenue, and first quarter of the year tends to do not as well. What's going on is not at all seasonal, right? I mean, these are all just form letter distractions. Revenue also depends on ad formats. We've always had all formats enabled. That's a total non-starter. And a viewer's geographic location will impact revenue. Please note that an advertiser has to be interested in advertising on your content. It may take time to build interest. Yeah, we've been building interest for 9 years and have 340-something thousand subscribers and you know, over 200 million views at this point. So this is exactly what I predicted. And it is as bogus as any of us would have imagined it to be. Basically, we have no idea what's going on. I've been texting all day with Kyle Kalinske from Secular Talk and some of my contacts over at the Young Turks and reading everything that's going on. And there's I want to clear up one other bit of confusion here, okay? Which is, people have been saying to me, David, the solution is simple. You go to your YouTube video manager and any videos that have a yellow dollar sign, meaning not monetized, you click on it and request it to be reviewed. People are not understanding the scope of what's going on. All of our videos are showing as monetized, okay? All of our videos are showing as monetized. There is what's going on is called ghost demonetization, where even though the videos show as monetized, there's no review to be done, no ads play, and as a result, we don't make any money, okay? Now, whether this is or isn't directly related to an attempt to move money from the YouTube platform and producers like me to corporate media. It doesn't matter if that was the goal of these articles that were written. That is the effect that this is having. Because if you are General Motors and you say, hey, our 50 million, we're pulling it from YouTube. On YouTube, that money was being divided among all sorts of producers. Corporate media, CNN's YouTube channel had advertisers. But a little piece of that GM money was coming to the David Pakman show. A little piece of that GM money was going to the Young Turks or Kyle Kulinski. So GM is still going to advertise. They're just going to go and now call up Comcast or NBC or whoever and say, hey, we've got 50 million we pulled from YouTube. We want to advertise with you. So whatever the impetus was for these reports that triggered this entire thing, whatever it was, the effect is it's hurting independent producers. It is reducing the variety of voices because ultimately we are committed to the YouTube platform because we have an audience there. But ultimately the money is going to have to come from somewhere else. And as a result, producers will have to make a decision. Am I going to produce content that is not going to be monetized? And this is a way to subtly influence what it is that's being produced. Now, my goal is to not change a damn thing about what we're doing. And if you look at the topics that we covered today, you will notice that we covered, in addition to covering what's going on with YouTube, it was all topics that we would otherwise cover. We interviewed the great Cass Sunstein on the show. We talked about the Mike Flynn immunity probe. We talked about white death rates keep climbing, and this is an ongoing issue that we've been following in the United States. I talked about Donald Trump leaving the room without signing executive orders in what is even more suggestive of maybe early symptoms of dementia. We are doing the show and we're putting it on YouTube as we've been doing, but the money is going to have to be made up for one way or another. And you know, I got an email, some of you know our segment producer, Noah Ferguson, and Noah does great work. He's researched many of our long form pieces. He assists with a lot of the stories that are on the show daily. Noah wrote to me and he said, you know, I've been reading about this YouTube thing, and if you need me to work for less money, I'll work for less money. It's not a problem for me. And I mean, it's think about what's going on here, folks, right? And I said to Noah, you know, fortunately, we have some runway here. This is a 40% cut to our revenue. The good news is that means we still have 60% of it, but we also have an audience that can very quickly undo what has happened here, the rug being pulled out, if they decide to support us directly. So for now, we don't have to lower anybody's salary. Noah's going to keep working with us in the exact same way he has been. Pat Ford, our producer, is going to keep working with us in the exact same way that he has been. But the money has to be made up for one way or the other. And here's the really good news, right? When you watched, I was going to say when you watch, when you used to watch a YouTube video and an ad played, we got a fraction of a penny. I think it was like 1/5 of a penny. So for every 5 people that watched an ad, we got 1 penny, right? So even if you watched all 160 or whatever of our monthly videos, that's only 32 cents that you were in essence providing to our channel. If you sign up for a membership for $3.60 a month, which is what it costs, you are immediately doing more than 10 times what you were doing before. And this is why, you know, I really believe, I played some voicemails on the show today from people saying, David, I'm glad that this is going on because you need to go off the air. I've been waiting for when the David Pakman show would go off the air. For every person like that, you know, if there's one person that says, I'm going to go to the website, davidpakman.com/membership, and I'll sign up, or I'll go to patreon.com/davidpakmanshow and throw a few bucks your way. Or when I shop on Amazon, I'll go to davidpakman.com/Amazon. If for every troll, we have someone who's willing to do that, we can overcome this thing. That's just the nature of the numbers. Okay. So on that note, if there's a wake up call here, it's that a lot of people take the concept of free content sort of for granted because you're watching a video and you don't realize that you are paying for the video with your attention. And there's a different way now which you can pay for the videos. And I hope that you will. You know, over the last 24 hours, we have had a lot of new members sign up, and it's been inspiring, but we need to do this for like 6 months to make up the lost revenue. Now, I do want to mention something else as well, and let's go through a couple things here. We have refreshed our Patreon, okay? If you go to patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow, which is also on the screen right now, you will see that you can become a patron. And I expressed concern yesterday about confusion between membership and Patreon. And let me just put it this way. Membership is something we've been doing for years. We have something called the bonus show. We have extra content for people, and you can check that out at davidpackman.com/membership. There's a coupon code you can use to sign up. It's IVoted17. If you don't care about that stuff, and maybe you're already on Patreon, you just want to send us some money to make up for what is being lost on YouTube, go to patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. Even a dollar a month you can do. And what I would love to do is, as you can see, when I took this screenshot just before we started, we had 42 patrons on Patreon. I would love to get to 100 by the end of this live stream. And even if it's just a dollar a month. Now, we do have higher levels. It's sort of a give what you can thing. And if the David Pacman Show is going to sort of get beyond this, it's going to depend on people signing up for membership at davidpackman.com/membership and going to Patreon at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow and making it happen. A few other things I want to address here, but first let me deal with some of the super chats that have been sent. Andrea Studebaker sent two $1 super chats with no question or comment. Thank you. John's History Channel sent a $1 super chat. Thank you very much. Evolutionary Solitude sent a $5 super chat saying, I'm creating an anti-racism YouTube task force. Contact me for coordinated reporting of racist channels. That's great. However, it's not going to help remonetize our channel, which is really the priority right now. Jennifer Corain says with a $20 super chat, also, we can add super chats as a way to help fund the show. I plan on tweeting those companies and YouTube. Yes, we need a shame campaign of every advertiser, and we need to specifically be reaching out to both YouTube and the advertisers that are boycotting, saying, you are hurting shows like the David Pacman Show, and you need to remonetize. And tweet it. Contact YouTube, contact the advertisers. There has to be a massive shame campaign. And I would actually go further. I would start contacting news outlets that you think might find this story interesting. This massive shift from corporate, from a broader base of producers on YouTube, companies pulling the money, and they're just going to send it. They're just going to send it to corporate media. Chad Rath sent a $10 super chat. I do news on YouTube. Also, I'm only 100 subscribers and over half my videos are unmonetized. Also, YouTube is going to lose big, in my opinion. I don't know that YouTube is going to lose big. And people have been emailing me saying, David, don't worry. YouTube is going to have to fix this because they're going to lose a ton of money. That is the wrong attitude for us to have. And that's why it is. That's why I've already went on Patreon and set up our patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow page to continue raising money to replace the lost revenue. Although in absolute dollars, there's a lot of money that YouTube is going to lose if they don't monetize news and politics. News and politics is tiny compared to the rest of YouTube. And this is why I think there are people that are missing. I initially also said, guys, YouTube will fix this. They need the money. They need the money just as much as we do. They don't need the money. News and politics is relatively small compared to other verticals, including gaming and the makeup world on YouTube and all of that stuff. So I am certainly not resting assuming that YouTube's going to fix it because they need the money. I don't think they need the money. And I think that that's exactly why we need to find alternatives. Patreon is one of those alternatives, patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. And membership is another one of those alternatives. If you go to davidpackman.com/membership, where if you want to pay the $6 a month or 60 for the year, by all means, that's great. I know that that's too much money for some people. And that's why we have a coupon code, IVoted17. It's all one word, all lowercase. And, you know, people have been writing in, and it's been great to hear from people about the fact that they support what we're doing. But we also need to turn that into action. And I'm glad that people have been doing that, and I hope people will continue to do it. As far as the membership coupon code goes, some people get confused about where that goes. You go to davidpakman.com/membership. You select a monthly membership or a yearly membership, and you click on the red button to sign up. And then in the coupon code field, as you can see here, I've entered, this is a hypothetical member named David Cuckman. We don't really have a David Cuckman, but we could, right? This member has inputted the coupon code, I voted 17. And as a result, when they sign up, they will get a 40% discount off of membership. And of course, we also have the Patreon fundraiser going, David Pakman, patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow. They're all happening, okay? And again, I would like to get to 100 patrons before we end the live stream. We were at 42 when we started the live stream. We are up to 45. Let's keep it going, okay? patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow. Let's look at some other super chats that are going on here. Andrea Studebaker sent another dollar super chat. Thank you very much. Jay Beatty sent a £3 super chat saying ice cream scoop. All right. Well, if that was worth £3, by all means, that's great. HopSH27 sent a $2 super chat. Thank you very much. And IngyBingy2000 sent a $5 super chat saying, I think a class action defamation lawsuit against the Wall Street Journal for misrepresentation of what YouTube is more than reasonable. All right. I don't know. We will see if lawsuits are brought. Stabby666 sent a £5 super chat saying, maybe it would be better to impress upon the advertisers that if corporate media has a monopoly due to less competition, they will charge more. Yes, I think that there is probably something to that. And I think that would be something interesting to look into. Absolutely. No doubt about that whatsoever. A couple other things I want to mention here. People have been saying, David, what are the different possible paths forward in this YouTube advertiser boycott? And again, we are talking about the total shutdown, effectively, on any number of progressive talk channels of all advertising on YouTube. If you go to our channel, you will see that essentially no videos have ads running on them right now. I don't know how long it's going to last. So here's some of the hypotheses that I've been hearing from people that I've been talking to today. Number one, this is completely temporary. Within hours, everything will go back to the way it is, and it'll be like this never happened. Everybody's going to go back to making what they were making on YouTube before. I find that to be an unlikely scenario. Another scenario is it's going to take a few weeks, but some portion of the revenue will come back, 50% of the revenue maybe 40%, maybe 60%, and then we would only have to figure out a way to make up for about half of the lost revenue. That's a possibility. Another possibility, and more people I've been texting with today are saying, David, this is the new normal for shows like yours and for shows like ours, the other people that I was talking to. And we need to replace all the revenue, period. And it's going to be an uphill battle. It could take, I mean, conservatively, it could take 9 to 12 months to replace this revenue if there is not some, you know, what I would consider some kind of extenuating, not that I believe in literal miracles, but unless there were something akin to a miracle, it could take 9 to 12 months to replace that revenue. In terms of what could be remonetized, we are a pretty advertiser-friendly channel, right? Because we're on broadcast radio and TV, I don't swear on the show. And as a result, if there was some kind of a speech filter that is checking to see, based on auto-generated captions, whether there's profanity, that has never flagged our videos for demonetization. We don't really show gore or graphic images for the most part. So we basically have like a 99.8% monetization rate, or had up until 4 days ago through YouTube. So if monetization is turned back on at the broader level, I genuinely have no idea what would and wouldn't be monetized on our channel, because we've never really had an issue with that. It's possible that there would be some kind of third-party tool developed to more precisely filter what channels are advertiser-friendly and which aren't, but that's a real concern to me because I guess I'm skeptical about how accurately. Imagine a video that is anti-Semitic and a video I do exposing anti-Semitism. How is a third-party tool going to know the difference? And the idea, of course, would be that an advertiser would not want to advertise on a blatantly anti-Semitic channel, but presumably would want to advertise on a channel that is doing critiques of anti-Semitism elsewhere, right? I don't know how a third-party tool is going to be able to parse that and figure that out. So I don't know what the answer is going to be, but more and more people are emailing me and saying, David, you know, it's possible that it would be a third-party tool that is more sophisticated than either YouTube's algorithm or the relatively small team that YouTube has that's reviewing video. So I don't know what the answer is there. Thanks to the new patrons who have signed up at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow, we are facing a huge uphill battle to replace the 40% revenue that just disappeared overnight from the David Pakman Show as a result of what's happening with the YouTube advertiser boycott. Also, thanks to a lot of memberships coming in at davidpakman.com/membership, many people taking advantage of the 40% discount code. Remember, if you watch every single one of our videos on YouTube every month and you watched an ad before those videos, you were probably contributing about 30 to 35 cents to our channel. If you get a membership for $3.60 a month, you are 10 times over improving upon the level of support you were providing to us. So use the coupon code IVOTED17. We've got Ruben Escobar, James Miller. Who else do we have here? Ryan Weir, Brooks McFarlane, Jenny Sebastian, Jane Perkins, Teresa Turns, Alicia Bassett, Chase Oakland, Joshua Baker, Deb Rieselman, Benjamin Reither, Rachel Wu, Jordan Frakes, Rachel Wu already, Janet Revez, Jake Burdett, William Benyon, Marie Kelly, Kevin Lopez, Eric Ernst, Kathleen Palmer, a lot of people who are understanding the importance of what is going on here. And membership comes with perks. If you're sort of unsure about membership versus Patreon, if you just want to throw us a few bucks on a monthly basis, you don't care about bonus show perks, creating an account, blah, 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 just go to patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. Super easy. A lot of you I know already use Patreon. If you're interested in some of the member benefits that we provide, including a daily members only bonus show, full 1 hour videos rather than those 3 to 5 minute clips, etc., you can go to davidpackman.com/membership and sign up there. And if you want to use the coupon code, you'll get 40% off. That is IVOTED17. Are there any broader lessons from what's going on here? Yes, there are, which is, number one, even though the David Pakman Show has for many years been independent of corporations, we still depend, in a sense, on a really big corporation, and that's YouTube. And with the flip of a switch, we've got 340-something subscribers on YouTube, over 200 million views. And with the flip of a switch, all of that traffic still exists, but it is worth zero in terms of the funding it provides to us as producers. And we need to fix that. And the way forward clearly is by separating our content from funding. We'll still put the content on YouTube. It'll be available to everybody, timely, every day, the way it's been for years. But the funding will not be coming from YouTube, clearly. It'll be coming from individuals like you. We've got some other super chats to look at. GameFire74 sent a $17.76 super chat saying, sent you two emails today. One, how does individually soliciting advertisers impact your model? Well, we need to start reaching out to individual advertisers, but that takes a lot more labor hours, right? So that's an area where we need help. If you work for a company or own a company that might want to advertise, let's get in touch, right? If you have companies that you currently are a customer of and you believe they should be advertising with us, email them and say, advertise with the David Pakman Show. You will reach more potential customers, people like me. So I think that is important. Number two, Gamefire is asking, to be clear, does requesting review from YouTube do nothing? Okay, let me explain this. On YouTube, if an individual video, because there are tags like, for example, ISIS or something like that, individual videos can be demonetized. And when this happens, when we look at our video manager, we see a green dollar sign next to videos that are earning money and a yellow dollar sign next to videos that are not. And what you can do is click on that yellow dollar sign and say, I think this video is okay, please review it again. And YouTube presumably then has a human look at it. And sometimes they approve monetization or sometimes they don't. That process still exists. We're not experiencing a problem with that. When you look at our video manager, every video for the last 60 videos has the green dollar sign. The videos have not been demonetized at the video level. We've got a bigger problem, okay? The entire channel has been demonetized. No ads are running on essentially all of our videos. There's no review to ask for because monetization has not been turned off for individual videos, right? It's affecting our entire channel. Kyle Kalinske, by and large, is experiencing the same issue, and I've been texting with him about it. It's not that a lot of videos have been demonetized individually, although some have. It's that ads just are not playing, okay? So that's the answer to that question. Annie Gee sent a $10 super chat saying, can't keep us down, David. I'm 70 years old and love your show. Thank you very much. Issy Serepi sent a 200 euro super chat, by far the biggest we've ever received, saying, you'll make it. Thank you so much, Issy, or Icy. I hope I'm pronouncing your name. I hope at least one of those two ways was correct. Kirk Fontaine sent a $5 super chat saying, sounds like a conspiracy to me to cancel independent media, keep fighting. Here's the deal. I speculated a little bit about this. It doesn't actually matter whether this was a deliberate move by the Wall Street Journal to try to get big advertisers to pull money from YouTube or whether that is merely a side effect. Here's why it doesn't matter. The impact is the same. The big advertisers have an ad budget for the year. They are going to spend the money. If they don't spend it on YouTube, where small shows like ours get a morsel, we get a little piece of it, but it adds up. They'll just put that money into legacy media, corporate media, call it what you will. So whatever the intention was of the journalists, writers, reporters that have been pushing the sky is falling, YouTube is out of control narrative, whoever has been pushing that, for whatever reason it's been pushed, the impact will be money away from producers like us, money to legacy and corporate media. Quick update. We are trying to get to 100 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow. For $2 a month, you can contribute at the TDPS patron level. For $5 a month, you can contribute at the TDPS producer level. For $25 a month, you will be a senior producer. $100 a month, executive producer, and there are higher levels. And if you're just contributing a dollar, that's more than okay. Every single dollar is a dollar we don't have to make on YouTube. We started the live stream with 42 patrons. We now have 51 patrons. Even if you can only throw a dollar, I encourage you to do that. Go to patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow. And I think if we can get ourselves to 100 patrons here before the end of the live stream, that would be a big success. Kirk Fontaine, okay, we dealt with that. We have a $200 super chat from Allison Strecker. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Very, very much appreciated. This is the kind of generosity that confirms to me that people get what's going on here. And I mentioned this earlier, and I'll mention it again. You know, yesterday I did this stream where I basically broke the news to the audience about how this was affecting us. And I emailed producer Pat right away and said, listen, this is what's going on. You're obviously going to hear about this. I don't want you to panic, but here's sort of the big picture of what's going on. And I let our segment producer, Noah Ferguson, know as well. And I mentioned this earlier. Noah wrote to me. He looked at what was going on. He checked out the live stream from yesterday. Noah wrote to me and said, David, if you need me to work for less money, reduce my salary, and I'll keep doing all the same work, I can do that. I think that that's something I can do, at least in the short term. And I said, I don't need you to do that, Noah. We're working on replacing this revenue, even though as soon as I announced this, emails started coming in, voicemails started coming in. I played one of those voicemails on the show today from people reveling in the 40% cut to our revenue that I announced. I think that there are more people that not only value the show, they value it enough to say, I'm actually going to do something to prevent this show from being damaged by this YouTube advertiser boycott. So we've got two ways. And you know, in the end, this is a reality about YouTube. When we make money off of YouTube, we split the money with YouTube. When ads show, YouTube makes as much as we do off of those ads. When you sign up at davidpakman.com/membership, we get 97% of that money. 3% goes to processing the payment. We get 97% of the money when you sign up on our website. When you go to patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow, we get 90% of that money. Patreon, you know, charges there's the same 3% payment fee, and they take a little bit. So it's actually a much more direct support when you're supporting us through our website or through Patreon. So absolutely, please do that. Let's continue to see what's going on at on the Super Chat. Matthew Gettle sent a $5 Super Chat. Thank you. Kevin Bragdon sent a $25 Super Chat. Thank you. Yujin Zhao sent a $10 Super Chat. Thank you so much. And Floppy Kid sent a $10 Canadian Super Chat. Giving what I can, we'll look into membership today. Things are dire now, but you'll get through it. I hope that's the case, because we've been doing this for too long to say we're going to let the effectively it's News Corporation, because that's Wall Street Journal. That's how this thing started. We've been doing this for too long to let the Wall Street Journal create such chaos that it makes it so we can't keep producing an hour broadcast show 5 days a week like we've been doing. So I hope you're right. It is certainly my plan, Floppy. I don't know if Floppy is your first name and Kid is the last name. It's certainly my plan to make up this shortfall. Okay, a lot of people are getting banned, and that's a good thing, okay? If the idea is you're going to come in here and troll, we're just not going to tolerate it. The moderators have been deputized to do what it is that they feel they need to do to keep things organized in the chat. The chat is a valuable tool. I know that a lot of the trolls are really, really sad people who don't have much better to do than to just harass others online, but it's not gonna happen on our channel, okay? So we've got 5 or 6 moderators, and the trolls are out in force. And you know what? If anything, here's the thing. I don't think the trolls realize this, but the fact that as soon as there's a financial calamity for the show, the trolls show up and seem to be relishing in the possibility that the show will go off the air, that confirms why we need independent media and alternatives to corporate media. And that's why all of this money being pulled from YouTube that will inevitably end up on corporate media needs to be made up for. The fact that the trolls are swarming like vultures on a dead carcass tells us just about everything we need to know. And you should have seen my voicemail line. We have a voicemail number on the show, and we get, you know, voicemails from people and we play them. there were a lot of people. I played one of them, and you can check it out if you look it up. If you look up the clip on our YouTube channel, people saying you deserve to go off the air. I hope you go off the air, and we're going to do everything we can to prevent that from happening. Let's deal with the continued super chats that are going on. D.W. Washburn, $10 super chat. Keep doing what you're doing, David. Thank you very much. Mexicano TV sent a $5 super chat. Hope this helps. You are the best news show on YouTube. Thank you. Jen Rhodes sent a $2 super chat. Just tuned in. Will this destroy Blaze and Alex Jones? You know what? In the chaos of all this, I don't even know what's going on with Alex Jones. Let's see if he has any videos on this. The thing about Alex Jones is I won't sell you bullshit products, right? These supplements and all this garbage, male vitality, female vitality pills, blah, 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 blah. We sell coffee, right? You go to davidpakman.com/gear, you get coffee. Coffee's very straightforward. You brew it, then you drink it. That's it. We're not promising anything other than that it has caffeine. And we sell t-shirts and bumper stickers. So Alex Jones has this whole other side of his business, so they may actually be okay. I'm not seeing on Alex Jones's recent videos anything about this. Now, I wonder if I click... This is a test, folks. Alex Jones has a video called Islamic Man is Prime Suspect in St. Petersburg Attack. Based on what YouTube is saying is the new monetization policy, that should not be monetized. And it is not monetized. Okay, well, listen. Let's be glad about that, because I think I might have lost my shit if Alex Jones had a monetized video about Islamic terror or whatever. The Blaze I know less about, so I'm not able to comment on that. Joseph Bleasdale sent a £5 super chat. Greetings from Britain. Sorry about Murdoch and the Times. Getty Germany sent a €10 super chat for the Empire. Thank you very much. Tony Merritt sent a £5 super chat saying, do you reckon Mike Pence ran as Trump's running mate simply because he reckoned it was a golden opportunity to become president of the United States? Yeah, a lot of people have proposed that to me. That what if it's James Comey and Mike Pence who are going to line it up so that Trump ends up out and Mike Pence ends up in? You're not the only person who's been thinking of that. A $1 super chat coming in from Stop the Violence Movement Chicago. Thank you. And Michael McCune sending a $2 super chat. Thank you very much. Also, big thank you again to $200 and a €200 super chat here during the live stream. Both the biggest that we've received. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Really, really appreciate that. Let's get an update. What's going on with our Patreon account? We are up to, what is the number? 54 patrons. So we started at 42. We are up to 54 patrons at patreon.com. I am going to add the become a patron. I'm adding the link to the description for the video just so people can easily find and click that. I would like to get to 100 patrons by the end of this live stream. If 46 people just go to patreon.com/davidpakmanshow right now and throw in even just $1 per month, we'll get to those 100 patrons, and I think that would be a really great start. That's going to be a platform that we need, okay? No doubt about it whatsoever. And let me do some thank yous to people who have been signing up on the website. Cassie Brody, Kevin Bragdon, Sherilyn Williams, Victoria Rodriguez, Eric Wenning, Kirk Fontaine, and Linda Adnoy have pledged on Patreon. Thank you so much. Arlana Hadley is a new member. Sean McQuarrie is pledging at patreon.com/davidpakmanshow. Kathy Healy has pledged $4 at patreon.com/davidpakmanshow. Can we beat $4? Marta Nieto has signed up for membership. Jamie Randall has signed up for membership. Cameron Cross is pledging at patreon.com/davidpakmanshow. So a lot of people clearly understanding the urgency here, as well as Elvis Harvey and Lee Clark, who just signed up. So thank you very much. Let me reset what we're talking about here, okay? So I'm seeing confusion in the chat. Some people are saying, David, are no advertisers willing to buy ads on your show or whatever? This is not the issue. The issue is that due to some articles that were written exposing that major brands had ads show up on YouTube next to the next to openly racist content, YouTube has basically pulled advertising from any channel that's even remotely controversial. This has led to, effectively, of our 14,000 videos or whatever the number is, we have effectively no ads running on YouTube. This represents about 40 to 42% of our total business. And this is something we're going to have to make it up. Okay. We're going to have to make it up one way or the other. And if it takes me coming out here and saying, hey guys, let's make it up a dollar at a time on patreon.com/David Pakman Show, we're going to do it. Okay. And if it takes me talking about what's going on, then that's just what's going to happen because, and I'll do it in addition to the hour and 20 minutes of content that we're producing daily. We're producing the content in the studio, and then I'll come home and do the live streams because we can't let the show die, right? 99% of the shows that started when our show started more than 10 years ago don't exist. They were not able to get to viability. We got to viability. This is a setback, but we can make it up, okay? Let's go to the super chat. We've got a $5 Canadian super chat from Aconite Blossom. Thank you. We have a $5 super chat from Reflection Eternal 2. If people need to pay membership to watch their YouTubers, there's a real possibility that it will come into direct competition with Netflix, Hulu, etc. Listen, YouTube started something called YouTube Red, which I think costs 10 bucks a month some time ago. For 10 bucks a month, you see ad-free. You can support our show. If you have YouTube Red and you watch our videos, we get a portion of the YouTube Red revenue. I can't stop you from signing up for YouTube Red and looping a playlist of our videos. If you were to do that, what could I do? I wouldn't be able to do anything about that. And that is a way that YouTube would continue passing revenue along to us. Chad Rath sent a $2 super chat saying, Paul Joseph Watson of InfoWars has a video on this. If someone can link to that in the chat, I'd be interested to hear what he has to say or tell me what he had to say about it. Nikki Ray sent a $10 super chat saying, thanks for all the great work you do at your channel. Your voice is important. Thank you, Nikki. A $20 super chat from Winky Dink Media saying, stay tough, homie. Yeah. Winky Dink Media, definitely check out the Winky Dink Media channel. Their channel is a similar size to ours. They've got 324,000 subscribers, and I happen to know that if you go to their channel, there is a noticeable lack of ads on a lot of videos. And that is something for you to take a look at as well. Thanks to Winky Dink Media for sending a $20 super chat there. The show continues, okay? I interviewed on today's program truly one of my favorite Boston area thinkers, Cass Sunstein. And as some of you know, I recently read the book Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman. This is a top book, okay? It doesn't matter what you do in life, you should read this book. And if you page through it, you can see that. Can you see there? It's not really in focus. Half the book is underlined, something I do when I read books, because there's just so much important stuff here. And that's a book where Cass Sunstein is cited often. And I had the real pleasure today to interview Cass Sunstein. We had a really good conversation about echo chambers and what Peter Boghossian would call doxastic closure, okay? Look that one up if you want a fun hour. And that conversation, if you were, that video, the standalone video is not yet on YouTube, but if you were a David Pakman Show member, you would be able to already see that interview because it was part of today's members-only commercial-free show. So go to davidpakman.com/membership, sign up there, coupon code is IVoted17. We're working to replace a 40% hit to our revenue that we experienced as a result of effectively all ads being cut from our YouTube channel. Not only can you become a member, you can become a patron at patreon.com/DavidPakmanShow. Link in the description to this live stream. We are up to 60 patrons. We started the stream with 42. We're at 60. Help us get to 100 patrons, okay? We can do it, even just $1 a month. Membership is anywhere from, you know, $3 to $6 a month, and it has benefits. You create an account, et cetera, et cetera. If you don't care about that and you say, David, I just want to throw you a few dollars to make up for the lost revenue from this YouTube crisis, you can go to patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. That's patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. Let's get to 100 patrons. And helping us get there, Corinne Mitchell just pledged $2. Jennifer Corain just pledged $5. Jamie Miller pledged $2. Patrick Babcock pledged $2. Lawrence Devon Sparrow Jr. pledged $2. Patrick Taylor pledged $5. David Brokaw has increased his pledge from $1 to $2. So people are doing it, okay? If we can build on that every day and we can continue growing membership, we might be okay. And we wouldn't even care what the YouTube monetization policy is then, because we just wouldn't need YouTube's help anymore. New members who have just signed up: Dale Carter, Erica Nelson, Scott Stewart has signed up, Nicole Crudup, Raven Mollisey has signed up. Thank you. Thanks to everybody who is signing up. This is really doing a lot to try to make up for this disaster that we have going on. The super chat is active, so let me get back to it. Black Girls Eat Green sent a $10 super chat saying, Trump for 4 years and no David Pakman show? Oh, hell no. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was my feeling exactly. Chris Harris sent a $5 super chat. David, as an Argentine Spanish speaker, are you able to understand European, Italian, or Portuguese? Portuguese is generally pretty easy to understand if people speak slowly. Italian is even easier to understand if people speak slowly because it is so similar to Spanish. So yes, that is something I am mostly able to do. Let's continue with super chat. $10 super chat from Brian Hernandez. This has to do more with people like Sargon of Akkad giving cover to racist and white nationalist views than anything else. Shocking companies don't want to advertise on videos that compare feminism to cancer. I haven't seen that video, but I can only imagine that advertisers are probably not big on putting their ads, their brand, in front of a video that compares feminism to cancer. Yes, yes, you're probably right about that. GameFire74 has sent a $7.11 super chat. Hope my question didn't seem disrespectful. Just want to help. Your show rocks. I like TYT, etc., but your show is very smart. I did not find anything about your earlier super chat disrespectful, by no means. Stop the Violence Movement Chicago sent a $5 super chat. I'm currently struggling financially, but I want to support you. I want other shows like yours on YouTube. I watch other shows like yours on YouTube. I really appreciate what you're doing, bro. Thank you. Thank you very much. The Banana Service Repair Center has sent a $5 Canadian super chat with no comment or question. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Let's get an update on where we are on Patreon, because Nellie Katzwinkle has pledged $2 there, and we are now up to 61 patrons. Let's keep it going. Let's get to 100 patrons, okay? In fact, let's do this. I'm thinking out loud here, okay? If we can get to 100 patrons by 7:45, let's say, okay? That gives us 22 minutes to get to 100 patrons. I will create a custom coupon code on our website right now. I'm logging in right now. It's not a coupon code I'm going to mention anywhere else. I will only mention the coupon code on this chat. And rather than 40% off, it will give you 55% off the membership of your choice, okay? It will only work for an hour after this stream ends. All we've got to do is get to 100 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. I will create right now a clever coupon code that I will then give you once we get to 100 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. So let me get myself logged in and we can make that happen while we chat here. What would be a funny, let's see. I think I've got an idea for a funny coupon code. I think the coupon code itself is funny enough to warrant to warrant seeing what it is. It will be sort of an ode to the trolls, and it will be a 55% discount. The coupon will expire, and it will be good on all memberships. I'm setting this up right now. And the coupon code, I think you're going to like this. All right, and we are making this coupon code live. As soon as we get to 100 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow, even if it's dollars, okay, I will announce a coupon code which will only work, I've set it up to work until midnight Pacific time tonight, and it will give you 55% off of membership, and the coupon code itself is hilarious. Kevin has just pledged. Ashley Dierolf has just pledged. Let's keep the pledges going while we chat here, and we will make that happen. Jermaine Zepeda has sent a $25 super chat. Awesome show. Only intelligent people value your show. Keep it up. Idiots will hate you more now after this is over and things normalize. Daniel Izumihara, $50 super chat. Thank you. No question or comment. Much appreciated. Chimp Hands sent a $2 super chat saying, "Hey Nong Man, I love your work, important stuff." And Wands 46 sent a $20 super chat. "Thank you for your objectivity. It is very much appreciated." I like the use of the term objectivity. The lack of media literacy has many people who email me confused between neutrality and objectivity. And objectivity is really important. Neutrality can be false or fake. And the best example that I can give you of that is that if the Boston Celtics destroy the Los Angeles Lakers one day, and it's happened in the past many times, as many of you probably know, imagine if after that I said, we're going to do a chat about the game. And in order to be neutral, even though the Boston Celtics won according to the scoreboard, which is sort of like according to climate scientists, even though the Celtics won, we're going to spend half the show talking about how the Celtics won and half the show talking about how the Lakers won. Because I'm neutral. That's bogus, right? Objectivity versus neutrality. Really important media literacy concept to understand. And I appreciate that comment very much. Clarth1234 sent a $2 Australian super chat saying, "Shill the Discord, please. Also speak Spanish." So we have a Discord server that has been set up by our Reddit team. We have a David Pakman Show Reddit discussion forum, davidpakman.com/reddit. And on there, we have information about a Discord server where people can connect and talk to each other. And conversation is happening. If people have been on it and you want to tell me in the chat what's been going on there, I've not yet connected, but I plan to. I plan to connect. I'd be glad to mention it. Anyway, a lot of discussion, a lot of high-level discussions, and a lot of important things going on there. So yes, there is a Discord server. Also speak Spanish. You know, ever since I was a little kid, when I would tell people that I'm from Argentina and I speak Spanish, they immediately wanted me to speak Spanish as a sort of sideshow, like a goof. And I developed a real antipathy towards just speaking Spanish on command for the fun of it, because it's just language, right? It's speaking. So I'm not against speaking Spanish if the circumstances demand it, but I'm not big into just speak Spanish on command stuff. Floppy Kid sent a $5 Canadian dollar super chat saying, "My name is Sam and I just signed up, stuck with this stupid YouTube name past few years." All right, well, Floppy, I now know you as Sam. I believe you can change your screen name though. Look into that. Let's take a look at what's going on with Patreon, because I know that there is, we are inching closer. We are up to 65 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. When we get to 100, and I'm only going to be on the stream another 15 minutes, if we can get to 100 patrons by 7:45 p.m. Eastern, which is 17 minutes from now, I have created a coupon code, which is hilarious, and it will be good until the end of the day, which will give you a 55% discount off of membership, okay? So if that's something you're interested in, let's get to 100 patrons at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. We are inching closer because of the pledges of Andrew and Kevin and Deanna Bell and so many others. And if you don't want to wait and you just want to get a membership, you can do that at davidpakman.com/membership. There's an existing coupon code. It's not as bigly tremendous as the one I will give you if we get to 100 patrons, but it's 40% off, and that coupon code is IVoted17. Joseph Gable has sent an $11 super chat. Your channel is critically important, David. We need intelligent, honest left-wing media in the world. Keep doing what you're doing. I plan to, and that's exactly why we are not wasting any time and immediately trying to make up for the lost YouTube revenue right away. Kirk Fontaine sent a $15 super chat saying, disregard the last message about membership. I did get a notification that I did join. All right, you didn't need to spend 15 bucks in order to let me know that. But I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Yeah, so that's happening. And I am taking a look at some of what's going on our Reddit discussion forum. There's a lot of really good conversations there. More than 3,200 of our viewers and listeners are now subscribed at davidpakman.com/reddit. Now, this is really weird. I don't know how many of you are aware of my friend Benjamin Dixon. Benjamin Dixon has a show called The Benjamin Dixon Show, and he produces it out of my studio. Someone posted a video, and the title says, Sargon of Akkad says, imagine of masturbating black man reminds him of Benjamin Dixon. There's got to be some typo there. Let me see what this is all about. But this is very, very weird. I don't know what on earth this could be a reference to. But it's kind of freaking me out. Let's see.
I don't know why my first thought was Benjamin Dixon, but it just, that's precisely what I imagine he looks like in the act.
Wow, yeah. So Sargon of Akkad, yeah. If we're trying to figure out what the hell is going on with advertisers pulling advertising, advertisers probably are not going to be eager to put their name on someone saying Ben Dixon looks like a cartoon of a masturbating black man. Wow. Anyway, a lot of interesting stuff happening on our Reddit discussion forum, davidpakman.com/reddit. Let's see what other super chats we have going on here. Athena Harding says, vegan Pat should not allow his cat outside. It's bad for bird populations. Love the show otherwise. Pat just can't catch a break. And animal activist Pat Ford talked about his cat and how it's an outdoor cat, and he feels good about it being an outdoor cat because it's in its environment. And Athena is saying that bird populations are damaged by having cats roaming around. I'm guessing because cats kill birds. That did not cross my mind, Athena, but I will pass the message along to Pat. Daniel Sullivan sent a $5 super chat. Love the show. Please continue to have ridiculous freeze-framed facial expressions as thumbnails for your live videos. I find them amusing. I will. Wes Smoke sent a $13.14 super chat. Jules M. sent a $20 super chat saying, can you just fill me in on the title of this live stream? I came in late. Let's reset. No, I think it's a good point, Jules, and thank you for the super chat. Here's what we're talking about. 4 days ago, David Pakman Show YouTube revenue fell off a cliff. On March 31st, the YouTube channel made, I think it's $68. On April 1st, which is the most recent day we have data for, the YouTube channel made 40-something dollars, okay? The reason for this is that as a result of an advertiser boycott of YouTube, YouTube has shut down all ads running on many news and politics shows. My show is affected. Kyle Kalinske's Secular Talk is affected. The Amazing Atheist TJ Kirk's channel is affected. The Young Turks are affected. You will be hard-pressed to find more than 1 out of 5 videos of theirs running an ad right now. And so what we're talking about is the repercussions of that. And we also are talking about that we don't want to end the David Pakman Show. And we're talking about ways to replace that revenue. One of those ways is by signing up for a membership at davidpakman.com/membership. Another way is by becoming a patron at patreon.com/davidpakmanshow, where we are up to 67 patrons. I don't know if we're going to make it. We have 11 more minutes to get to 100 patrons. Even if you just donate a dollar, that counts. to make this a little easier, to make it more likely that we'll get there, because I do want to give you, if we get to 100 patrons by 7:45 Eastern, I've got a coupon code that is going to blow you out of the water, because the coupon code itself is hilarious and it'll also give you 55% off membership. Let's say that if we get to either 100 patrons by 7:45 or $300 per month by 7:45, and this would allow a couple of big donors to get us there, I will let loose the new exclusive coupon code that will only work until midnight tonight. In the meantime, thanks to VJ, Doug, and Benjamin Ramos, as well as Bruce Achola, and I think I already mentioned Deanna Bell, all of whom have pledged at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. Link is in the description for the live stream. Also, thank you to Cody Compton, Cheryl Dayton, Valencia Whitehurst, Jenny Rose, Samuel Christensen, Quentin Todd, Brian Bransfield, and I think I already mentioned Matthew Goodtell, but if I didn't, he gets two mentions for signing up for membership at davidpackman.com/membership. A few more super chats here. DBark04 has sent a $5 super chat. I noticed that Pizzagate conspiracy theorist David Seaman and ultra-conservative Steven Crowder still have ads playing on their channel. What gives? Couldn't fucking tell you. Truly. I mean, it is shocking to me. Shocking to me that this is all about supposedly offensive content and, you know, debunked conspiracy theories that are ruining people's lives, ruining James Alefantis's life, the owner of Comet Ping Pong. And those channels are still showing ads. It is stunning to me. I could not answer to you why that is. Chimpans, what percentage do you get from Super Chats? $2. I don't know. I think it's probably the same split, like 60-40 or something like that. That's a good question. $5 Super Chat from Alexander Bergman. Why do you often cite mainstream media journalists when justifying positions? Always remember that New York Times helped push us into war with Iraq. It's not that we justify positions by citing so-called mainstream media journalists. It's that, you know, we do a commentary and analysis show. And so I don't want to be citing fringe news websites. So to at least establish the factual basis for our analysis, we kind of have to cite other sources, and we want to choose sources that are, you know, that are considered relatively at least accurate on the facts. Okay, so don't confuse justifying positions by citing corporate media for basic facts. Cigar Desai sent a $2 super chat saying you'll make it through this. Erica Jessen sent a $7 Canadian super chat saying not much, but I hope this helps. Independent media is critical. It absolutely is. And there is a $5 Canadian super chat that says merely, message retracted. Message retracted. All right, I wonder what that's about. We are getting closer on Patreon. We are down to 7 minutes before I let loose this 55% membership discount code. We have Derek Klar, Julie Morgan, Charles Black, Nicholas Bennett, Nate Osherman, and Mark Kaltenborn, who have all made pledges ranging from $1 to $10 at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow. We are up to 75 Patreons and 200 patrons and $206 per month. If we can get to 100 patrons or $300 per month by 7:45 p.m. Eastern, I have a doozy of a coupon code for you that will give you a 55% discount off of membership. And I think people will find the code itself pretty exciting. Pretty exciting. Another message retracted super chat. I wonder what that's about, because I know that you can't get a refund when you send a super chat, but I guess you can retract the message and then we still get the money. I've not seen that before today, but clearly people very, very excited about the ability to retract messages. Please do participate in discussions about the future of the show. A lot of those discussions happen on our Reddit discussion forum, davidpackman.com/reddit, R-E-D-D-I-T. Please follow me on Instagram. And I think what I'll actually do, people might find this interesting. People have asked before, what am I looking at when I am streaming. So I'm going to take a screen, a picture of what I look at when I am streaming, and I will put that up on the screen, and I will also actually show you what the super chats look like. I'll put a couple of these on my Instagram. I'm on Instagram at david.pacman. And follow me there. Right after we're done, I will, I'll post what this looks like, and I think people will enjoy it. $2 super chat from Sivan Bear Ariel. Thank you so much. Meat Mountain has sent a $5 super chat. Keep up the good work, David. Please tell Kyle Kalinske to do something like this. America needs you guys. Pizza. Not Pizzagate, but just pizza. Who doesn't like a good pizza? Who doesn't like a good pizza? We continue to get closer to 100 patrons with the patronage of Daniel Izumihara. We are now up to, with 5 minutes to go in this thing, I'm kind of getting excited. I'm genuinely curious whether we'll get to 100 patrons or $300 a month. We're at 76 patrons and $228 per month. If we get to 100 patrons or $300 per month, I have a coupon code that I will tell you about. I will only mention it on this live stream. The coupon code will only work until midnight tonight, and it will give you 55% off of membership. Okay, so we are only $72 away or 24 patrons away with 4 minutes left. I don't know if we're going to make it. I genuinely don't know if we are going to make it there. People asking if the show is going to happen tomorrow. Absolutely. Absolutely, the show is going to be happening tomorrow. We are already looking at a lot of different stories for tomorrow. We will have part two of my interview with the truly great legal scholar, Cass Sunstein. We had part one of that interview on today's program, and we will have part two of that interview tomorrow. We're also going to be talking about what is essentially a monarchy relationship with China, in the sense that Jared Kushner, Trump's son-in-law, has been basically sent to China to diplomatically deal with them. And this is normally something that the State Department would do. And I'm going to talk about how this is reminiscent of a monarchy more than a democracy. We're going to talk about how opiate overdoses have dropped in states with legal marijuana. And when we talk about, you know, the scaled up war on drugs that we're seeing at under the Jeff Sessions Justice Department, we see that where marijuana is legalized, opiate deaths are down drastically. We will also talk about Donald Trump once again playing golf, his 14th game of golf in 10 weeks. It's not a story about golf per se. It's really a story about lies, double standards, and a total lack of fiscal conservatism. We're going to be talking about that on the program tomorrow. I will also give you the latest update on the YouTube ad boycott. Things are happening every few hours, so there will probably be more to discuss there. Senate Democrats have also reached the filibuster threshold for Donald Trump's Supreme Court nominee, Neil Gorsuch. Now we need to look at whether Republicans are going to use the nuclear option. I believe that Gorsuch should be held up for as long as possible. It was completely bogus that President Obama's nominee, Merrick Garland, was held up because it was Obama's last year of his presidency. It makes absolutely no sense. And we have a president who's under investigation for possible collusion with Russia. There is no reason. There is no reason whatsoever that we to put through Neil Gorsuch, period. We are only 2 minutes from the 7:45 deadline where we were hoping to have either 100 patrons or a $300 per month commitment on patreon.com/DavidPacmanShow. If we make it, I will give you a coupon code that will give you 55% off of a David Pacman Show membership. If we don't, alas, we will have to wait for the next live stream. And at that point, I will again create some kind of milestone to provide a big league membership discount. But you know what? The good news is you don't actually have to wait for any coupon code, because we have a coupon code that's active right now. It is IVoted17. You can go to davidpacman.com/membership, select the membership of your choice, replace some of the lost YouTube revenue, which is now up to 40%. 40% of our revenue has disappeared effectively overnight as a result of the YouTube advertiser boycott. You can get a 40% discount with the coupon code IVOTED17. I think we may not make it because we are seconds away. We are at 81 patrons with $252 per month pledged. And that is not 100 patrons, and it is not $300 per month pledged. I really want to see this happen, but I also recognize that if we fail to get there, it would be bad form for me to just give out the coupon code. So here's the happy medium. We're going to give it 5 more minutes. If by 7:50 p.m. Eastern time, we can get to either 100 patrons or $300 per month at patreon.com/DavidPackmanShow, I will give the coupon code. I have issued an extension. And I think you guys are going to like this. Because on that note, on the buzzer, we have received, we've got the best audience. Cynthia Knight has just pledged $100. And that has pushed us over the $300 threshold. This is what we call for the greater good. Cynthia Knight putting us over the threshold. So we have a 55% discount code. All right, get ready to write this code down. I think you're gonna like this. This code will work until the stroke of midnight. I don't know if Pacific or Eastern time. I'm actually confused about that now. It will give you a 55% discount off of the membership of your choice, whether it's the $6 a month membership or the $48 a month membership or whatever. The coupon code is all one word, all lowercase, cucked no more. CUCKEDNOMORE. All right. Thanks to the $100 pledge of Cynthia Knight, we have achieved the goal. And you can now get 55% off of your membership at davidpackman.com/membership by using the coupon code CUCKEDNOMORE. Now, cucked may not be that common of a word in the vocabulary of many people. So I will make sure I just spell it for you. CUCKEDNOMORE. All one word, all lowercase. Thanks to everybody who joined me. We will stay on top of this. We will keep streaming. Please contact YouTube, contact boycotting advertisers, contact anybody who will listen. We're doing it every day and tell them you need to remonetize news and politics channels like the David Pakman Show. Thanks to everybody who joined me today.